Oh, I can't move people.
I'll move myself.
Yeah, I'll move myself as well.
All right, so here we are with the Banjo Race Novice Tournament. Treppy K versus Snowman. 7 minute difference on the PB, not too bad. Should be a good race. Got a little bit of a difference. Xbox versus N64. What happened to Snowman? Did he miss a backflip or something? I mean, not the backflip, but like going up to, or like bottle stacks or something. I don't know. Anyway. It's weird because on Spiral, he's only like, he got a 211 Spiral, but then he's like super behind, so I don't know. Seeing Snowman doing the newest Mumbo's Mountain route, going to Ticker's Tower immediately. Getting a couple notes on the hill up there. Making our way through Mumbo's here. Thanks, Crosby. Yeah, I saw the title was right. I didn't know if the game would show up. The race is indeed there, Gogo. How's it going, Eagle? Trep's route has really thrown me off. I don't know. He's got 94 notes already. I'm just confused. Hey, welcome back, Ed. Yeah, I wasn't sure what you were planning on doing. But yeah, I'm gonna drop frames if I screen share through Discord, so you're not gonna have like the most accurate feed.
Yeah, it's alright.
Okay. Yes, Eagle, there is a fan noise in the background because there is a fan in the background. I didn't know what Trep's PB was, I just saw it on stream, he has a 224, so... What's up, Mr. Zebra?
Okay, I just synced up all my synced up, so I should be fine.
Nice. Yeah, I'm looking at 755, 656, 57, 58. It'll work out. Yeah, I was really confused. He's leaving a lot of stuff. He's doing a... So I guess this is RBA, right? Because he left stuff in Spiral Mountain and Mumbo's Mountain, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, sorry about the fan, guys. I have an audio compression software, but it, like... I swear it was mining Bitcoin or something in the background because my computer slammed to a halt whenever I had it running, so I stopped using it.
I can't hear the fan in the voice call.
Yeah, Discord doesn't have my voice. Like, the difference between OBS and Discord is, like, OBS is a hot mic and Discord is, like, voice activation, at least. Well, it's not recording the Discord audio. It's recording ad in the Discord, but it's not recording me through Discord. I mean, I can just turn my mic off completely and just have a race if you'd prefer. I'll get your name in here, Ad.
All right.
Yeah, it is interesting to see Clanker's second. That's not something I've seen since the Damageless tournament. Showman's getting a little tripped up on the stairs, but that's okay.
They always cause trouble, so.
According to LiveSplit on his stream, he's got a 217.55, so if he's comparing against personal best, then that is accurate, but if it's best or something, I don't know. Yeah, I think Snowman got a decent time yesterday in the BK League.
Yeah, he did.
Trep missed the bolt jump there. See how Nipper goes.
Yeah, let's see.
Not bad. I don't think this crab's gonna hit Snowman here. No, he's good. Okay.
Yeah, he's gonna.
Took Trep a little bit through the back flip, but not too bad. Yeah. Eagle, I think Seven Hornets trying to do a BK League race in 15 minutes.
That's fair.
Yeah, it's kind of tricky to get that one without landing. It's not too bad if you just nosedive into it and then shock pad jump up, because you at least skip the dance. Got a bunch of crabs on screen. Feels like I'm in the Northeast. Snowman taking it pretty safe, knocking the crab over. I usually go into there with 3 HP, and I've kind of gotten used to how the crab spins around in there. But yes, yeah, knocking it over is definitely safe.
Yeah, I usually go in there with 3, just to, like, be safe.
Yeah, looks like Snowman was minus 8.8 out of TTC there, so pretty good.
Yeah, not bad.
Looking like a pretty decent pace.
Yeah. Hey, Clenap. Hey, Phantom.
Yo, Clenap. Phantom, so Trep is playing on Xbox, and he's doing a slightly different route. Trep hasn't done Treasure Trove Cove yet, and Snowman has, so it's, you know, it's kind of hard to exactly tell, but oh no.
Probably after they're both done, you can see, because after Clankers, doesn't Snow do BGS or does he do RPA?
Well, yeah, so they're both going to be in Bubble Loop Swamp after as their fourth level, but Trep is going back to Mumbo's Mountain and Spiral Mountain, so.
Yeah. Forgot about that. Second Mumbo's Visit.
So it's kind of hard to compare directly, but you know, as long as these people are getting green splits, that's what we're all about.
Yeah.
Seeing the good gameplay. Let's see. I know Snowman got knocked off in the beginning, but his gloop cycle isn't too bad. I probably would have gone for the bubble first before getting that note.
Yeah.
Hikes is going to pick up another one on the other side. Yeah, learning the gloop cycle is really challenging because you need to have good movement consistently in the opening segment to have any grasp on where he's going to be and where you can anticipate him being, so. Definitely one of those hard tricks that just kind of you get used to after a while. I think Freeze EZ Peak as well. I see FP1 on Trap Splits.
Yeah.
Wait, does that mean we're gonna see Boggy Race as the B?
Oh.
Oh, baby.
I'm excited.
I haven't seen that since Asmi was doing No FFM. I wonder if that's an Xbox thing, or... Because I know on N64 it's not that difficult to get out of bounds as the B. At least in Clankers. See. Yeah, that would be problematic to recover from.
Yeah.
Jorge, we've got Xbox RBA versus N64.
Yes, Crypto, this is 100% for both.
Yeah, it really does stink to land on the Alcove Jiggy, because the best option is just to go do Nipper. Like, jump down, get the Honeycomb, go do Nipper, and then shock pad up, and then fly up to the Lighthouse.
Yeah, that happened to me during my... 1545 swap, and I didn't know what to do because I didn't know the backups.
Yeah, I definitely encourage no reset runs because you'll just get used to thinking on your feet and like what you actually need to do.
Yeah.
How much does CC2 save? I don't know. It's gotta be, like, slightly significant. Because you're skipping the Jiggy Jigs. I don't know how many Jiggies you get as the B. But you can also, like, fly pretty quickly and get the notes, so... Oh, it's only 6 seconds.
Wow.
it's probably due to just like routing back to it through the lair.
Especially for me, like in my 1.1 route, where I'm like extremely tight on Mumbo tokens because we use 5 on to get the termite. So like if I like miss a Mumbo token, that would like suck to find another one, so it's like good if I just have backups.
Yeah, it's it's something that I don't really have to consider, because the Mumbo token route with our RBA is like, it's kind of tight, but it's like pretty loose, because, you know, we don't have the 5 constraint that you do.
Yeah.
Like, do you get the Mumbo token behind Nipper ever?
I do get that one.
Yeah, definitely one of the first things I suggest doing if you ever get an Everdrive is just restarting TTC over and over and just trying to do each individual flying section.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's actually pretty wild how much time, like, in practice, you save using an Everdrive.
Yeah.
Just having a save state so you don't have to reset every time.
It's one of the things I, like, I'm expecting to get this year. Like, because, like, I have, like, a list of items I'm buying for, like, speedrunning, like, N64 cards and all that, and Everdrive's on the list.
It's just a neat collectible. Like, it's not super expensive. You know, it has a price point, but it's not like $1,000, you know?
Yeah.
Yes, so...
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, we're gonna be getting out to Bubble Gloop Swamp here. Yeah, mine took, like, 3 weeks or something.
I just love it how my Tui card came in with my capture card, and it's still yet to arrive.
Wait, your capture card hasn't arrived, or?
Like, yeah, I ordered like a month ago or something, and it's yet to arrive.
What
we
kind
got
of...
a refund on it, so we're probably planning on ordering another one.
Yeah. What kind did you get?
It's a GB.
The classic. Yeah, I had two. The first one, I don't know what it was. I had some power surges, and then the audio just went out in it completely. And then I got a new one, and it works fine. But I don't know if the old one works, if I just have to fandangle with something. But...
Oh.
Oh god, I'm so nervous seeing Trep, like, leave these notes behind. Even though I know he's gonna death warp, it's still just like, oh god.
The NC4 mindset is not prepared for the Xbox.
I don't think you can do FP early. I think it's something about the Beak Bomb clips. Because, like, on N64, it runs at a lower frame rate in some places, so...
You can do FP early? Damn.
It's probably also difficult with, like, the rounded controller. Around the joystick, I mean. Really nice hut jump section from Trep.
Yeah, they were clean.
What's up, Eric's?
Hey, Eric's.
Just chillin', casting the race.
Yeah, same.
Thank you. Yeah, I probably will make it like a really simple tutorial video for people on how to host.
Yeah, it'll be helpful for like new hosts.
Onboarding is the most difficult process known to man. Snowman wants all the HP.
Yeah. Especially since he's like very low. Or he was very low.
Yeah. That hit makes it difficult now. He's probably gonna have to use boots for the second section, so. Unless he goes for the honey hive.
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna get Panda Express tonight.
Let's go.
Pretty decent turtle pattern for Snowman there on the last one.
Yeah.
And hopefully nobody loses to Vile. So I am curious to see how Snowman handles this. He might just skip the second boots and then get the third boots.
Yeah, that might be safe. Oh.
Well, he probably won't lose to Vile then.
Thank you. is, Shinoman did a plan. So it's good that you don't fall.
Yeah. Yeah, falling there is definitely, like, one of the most demoralizing things.
Yeah.
Because, like, oftentimes you die. Like, you take fall damage and then the swamp damage. Or, like, even in best case, you just burn your gold feathers. Got double vial action going on here. Yes, Veege is correct. Yeah, I'm just... The Trep doesn't have a time on the leaderboard, and I'm just using the time that he has on his stream on his splits, so.
Oh, let's go. One of my musical compositions got accepted to an All-State competition challenge.
Nice.
Let's go.
Those are really fun. I hope you do well. What instrument is it on?
Yeah. It's not like a challenge, it's already done, because the challenge was like in November.
Oh.
But like, my thing got honorable mention this year.
Yeah, that's awesome. It's,
so yeah, and they're gonna present it to like the whole state, like, in like a Zoom.
Heck yeah.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, no, that's awesome, dude. Was it a solo, or was it an ensemble?
It was an ensemble piece. So yeah.
That's really cool, man. Yeah, one of my favorite experiences from high school band, we played in this jazz club. It was called Nighttown. And unfortunately, they closed down due to COVID. But it was, yeah, so I heard that news and I was like really upset. But it was a really awesome experience because it was like this old, like from the 20s place.
I think so far, my best experience in band is like. Probably, like, obviously marching band, because that's, like, always fun. And then, like, I think so far, like, learning French horn has been, like, something, like, that changed my, like, musical career. Like, that's when I realized, I'm good at this, like, music thing. I should, like, continue it.
Definitely. Yeah, once you, like, spend the time to get your bearings and anything, it's, you know, that's a lot of effort, so you should capitalize on your investment.
Yeah.
Indeed, Go-Go.
I agree.
All Alright, great news. Nobody lost a vibe.
Let's go.
P-Vigil? Yeah, I thought P-Vigil was... I know he did some emotes. In like a really cool style. Like I remember the hag anime, duck anime. And I think he made those.
That's awesome.
Welcome, Franz fan.
There's just, like, so many musicians in the BK community, like, you just can't list them. There's just so many.
Yeah, I mean, just look at Family Jewels.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, maybe Grant Kirkhope had some influence on that. Because, like, all of us are all just like, oh yeah, I fucking love the music. It's great. Sorry, I didn't curse out.
Oh yeah, there are a lot of people into science in the BK community.
Yeah, so looking at Trep's splits, he was minus a minute out of BGS, but, you know, he's comparing it to 224, and he's got a 218, what people saying? 216?
Yeah. So I agree with Zemermicus. all the Rareware games have catchy music.
Yeah, back in the time when you'd, like, actually purchase a video game soundtrack on a CD and listen to it. I gotta be honest, though, I think video game music really changed when Super Mario Galaxy came out. Because they used, like, a live recording studio for all those pieces.
Yeah. Yeah, because, like, nowadays, it's, like, it's more popular to, like, a whole orchestral recording in, like, all in one instead of, like, individuals.
Yeah, Go-Go, they're in old Nintendo Powers, they had a bunch of, like, CD promos and stuff like that. Behind here.
Yeah.
Should be alright.
Yeah, he should be good.
Ooh. So he's gonna have to get those notes later.
Yeah.
He definitely had time.
He's just trying to play it safe.
Yeah.
And I respect that.
Oh, yeah, Go-Go's super right. He's doing it as the B, so maybe it's different.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Jigsaw.
Yo, Tapu Koko. It's a cool Pokemon. Yeah, you can, like, hop off the sled. It's honestly pretty upsetting that, like, the whole trading card game community got, like, wrecked this past year. It's like, you can't have tournaments, you can't have pre-releases, like... And yet, the price of Pokemon cards still went up. Artificial scarcity. Yeah, I mean, imagine trying to organize an event for 1,000 players, like Nationals. Hehe, oh Go-Go. Pokemon TCG is super fun. It's honestly the most fun card game out there. I don't know, Magic is kind of cool, because, like, you just pop off with insane stuff all the time. But Pokemon's, like, consistency. And, like, a lot of thought.
Alright. Decent. That was a good body.
Yeah, pretty solid gameplay from both runners. Trep using a couple extra feathers there to get that note. used to like Yu-Gi-Oh! Before, the pendulums. I don't know too much about that. I know it's, there's like different summon types. Power creep is inevitable in most card games, unfortunately. Alright, so Trep lost about 40 seconds compared to his PB in Freeze Easy Peak. So. I saw they were coming out with an Uno like 50th anniversary edition, and they had like a coin flip aspect, and I don't know what the deal is with it, but there's a coin flip.
He's at low health.
It's a good thing there's a honey hive back here.
Oops. Accidentally dying.
I was confused. I didn't know if that was on purpose.
Yeah. I didn't know that when you die after doing GV that you spawn back at the, what's it called? Puzzle spawn or whatever.
Yeah, I guess technically that's the last loading zone you're in.
Yeah.
Because it like switches scenes.
Yeah, I don't know how that works, but I guess, yeah.
I don't think they really anticipated you dying much in the lair, so...
Yeah, it's true.
What's up, A72 Cool? Taking a visit to the hot springs. Ooh, I gotta reset Shikoman's timer here. I want to learn how to 3D print stuff.
Yeah. 3D printing sounds cool.
The door. That's such a weird thing with that egg on Napper.
Yeah, I don't know how it works.
It has something to do with, like, the cutscene starting and there being an entity that is the egg, like, in the specific location. I don't know. It has to do with, like the XYZ coordinates of where the egg is when you start the cutscene, I think.
Yeah.
Pretty nice graveyard section there from Trip.
Yeah. Oh, that's smart. Getting the notes, all the text boxes, finishing on Xbox. That's pretty smart.
Yeah, those are my favorite optimizations. I wonder if I had an Xbox, if I would have preferred to play on Xbox 64.
Yeah. I think what I would just like stay on N64, but that's just my personal opinion.
Yeah. I've just never been a huge fan of the Xbox controller. I don't know why.
Same.
Although my first exposure to it was like the original Xbox controller, which was huge. Oh, yeah, go, go. It's weird that that's inverted. but I guess when you're using a stick, it's a little different than a button.
Yeah, that's true.
Snowman is almost a minute behind his PB, but it's not been, like, particularly terrible. I think just the minor route variances are adding up. But should be all reconnected as we get into Furnace Fun, at the very least.
Yeah.
See how Snowman's graveyard section goes. Yeah, the flower pot section in the graveyard is pretty tricky, because it's hard to be certain if your egg's going to go in the pot, and then if it doesn't and you enter Talentrot, it's just like, well.
Yeah. So I'm like been DMing this like Steam admin because like I got a like false report and like the person who did the false report said it was a mistake, and I'm on the final part of like getting the like report revoked, and it says that they need me to give them 3 games from Steam and they'll give them to me for free.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
That sounds like a scam.
It's not, because it's literally someone from Steam.
Wait, so you're just getting 3 free games from Steam?
Yeah, it's a way to, like, unban. Because, like, it's just, like, literally the only way they have to do it.
That's pretty sick. Wait, I don't know what to suggest, even. But if there's a game that you don't own that I would recommend, Binding of Isaac.
Ooh, yeah. I'm getting Marbles, yeah.
Marbles is free, don't, it's free.
Wait, do I have Marbles? Actually, I don't know. I haven't looked at my Steam games in a while.
I remember when Marbles was a standalone client you had to download from the Pixel by Pixel Discord. And now it's on Steam.
Oh yeah, I think I want to like pick Tabletop Simulator. That's like something I've been looking into.
Oh yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, I don't know what you have, so.
Yeah, I definitely don't have Tabletop, so I can get that.
I'd recommend Fall Guys, but I haven't played Fall Guys since the first season.
I'll see what I can get.
Steam's great, though.
Yeah.
They're a solid company. Or Valve is.
I'm gonna get Cyberpunk for the meme.
Yeah, I don't know if you can run it, but
no, my PC can definitely not handle that. Can't even handle GTA.
Yeah, I'm with you. I probably couldn't play GTA. Gash's company. At least it's not the boring company. Womp womp.
I need to get Gary's mod. That's something I've been looking into.
If you have people to play it with, that's like the contingency for so many games.
That is true, yeah.
I'm mystified by this Gobi's Valley route. See what else Gobi's Valley 1 has in store for us.
Yeah.
It's so nice seeing all the objects rendered in Xbox when you zoom out.
Yeah. It's funny when you see some things in N64 that are just not loaded correctly.
Yeah. Yeah. And, like, the skyboxes on Banjo-Tooie are so nice.
Oh, yeah. I 100% agree.
I'm really nervous for Trup right here. He's probably just flying over, yeah. Oh, he's... Oh, my God. I would not have done that with 1 HP.
Crazy. Oh, jeez. Yeah, Trap is, like, actually playing, like, really risky right now.
Yeah. I mean...
Doing strats on... He's, oh, sorry.
He's just a minute ahead, that's it.
Yeah. He's doing strats that I wouldn't even do, like, with, like, 4 health. Or, like, not 4, but, like, 2 to 3.
Yeah. Even these mummies are kind of scary.
Yeah.
Snowman got a gold split there. He's only plus 30 now.
Let's go.
And he got the chair. Oh no! Oh wait, no, maybe he wanted to die. Yeah, he probably wanted to die. Really wanted that one blue egg? I'm confused. So is that it for Gobi's one? Fascinating.
That was interesting.
Yeah, Death Warp in the Water Pyramid. See if Snowman gets Gobi clip here. Kind of a weird camera angle. Gets it though. Snowman was a little early. Yeah, sometimes if you get the early egg on the carpet there, it's hard to get the note.
Oh,
Bishop should be okay here. It's funny seeing him, like, actually route in the extra life there, because it's probably necessary. Because if you void out with zero lives, then it's a game over.
Yeah.
Snowman with a pretty standard Gobi's Valley route here.
Yeah.
Gobi's is one of the most complex levels. There's like a whole flowchart based on RNG and like whether or not you do a certain trick.
Yeah. It's also the one I like struggle the most for some reason.
There's just a lot of places to take damage. That's nerve-wracking, getting that boss boombox jiggy doing a death warp.
Yeah.
It's crazy how fast, like, the death animation and the load times are. Like, that would take forever on N64. Gosh, oh man. Oh, he goes for lifeboat jump. And he gets it, wow.
Nice. Wow.
I always expected that cutting board in the kitchen to do damage to you. Walking in an oven with an open door?
Nope.
Walking in a knife? Totally fine. I wonder if the Xbox can soft lock in the navigation room there. Because on N64, if like both the grublins are stacked up on each other and they walk at you and you get hit, then the game just soft locks.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
I don't know. I think it's like getting hit at the same time by two enemies.
Hmm.
Or it might have to do with the objects in the room or something. I don't know. It's always fascinating to me, like, trying to wrap my head around, like, the reasoning in the code for why things happen in-game when you do stuff.
Yeah.
Like, some of the stuff in Zelda is insane, but it's like, well, it makes sense. Like, just writing items into your inventory. This was a really good Gobi's for Snowman.
Yeah, it was like extremely good.
Bit of an early split, but it was gold. Yeah, that's a pretty reasonable go-go. Trap is minus 3 minutes and 30 seconds now. Sorry, Koi, I didn't have a chance to make the command. I wasn't supposed to host this race, so I didn't get to talk to Yorb Skip, but we've got twitch.tv/trepbk and Mr. Snowman. I think it's Mr. Underscore Snowman.
Yeah, it's Mr. Underscore Snowman.
Yeah, with a zero. No, it's just, no zero.
No zero.
Yeah.
Snowman kind of struggling to get through the thing, but he got through.
The important thing is that you do get through.
Nice.
Oh, Snowman's doing the safe RBB. Dropping down to the fan blades before getting the Jinjo. Yeah, that's definitely one of the scarier swims in the game.
Yeah. Especially since it's after engine room.
Yeah. Yeah, because sometimes the timer on the propellers can be tight, so.
I remember in like one practice run of it, I was like, I had like 2 seconds after I left the fans.
Yeah, it can be nerve-wracking. What we really gotta do is we gotta clip through the stairway and then get the Jiggy behind the propellers inside of the ship.
Optimal.
It's really ridiculous because, like, you can get the Jiggy with Banjo's nose, like, if you're perfect, but if you go through just a little bit, then you're, like, in the propeller room. So it just kind of game over there. But maybe if you finish the level on it, it could have some value. I don't know. Yeah, it's really tough because the swimming momentum carries.
Yeah.
Oh god, the weatherman.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't really know what to expect here.
Nice.
Ooh, Trep with, or, I mean, Snowman with the optimal strat. If you enter this crate, not in Talentrot, and you shoot an egg here, just lined up with the honey hive.
Oh, Trep, you fell. Oh.
It's a good thing he got that extra HP. Oh no, what a tumble. There's that bird cutscene. That's usually where people have to take care of a bird. Oh god, no! Make it back. Oh no! Ooh. I think he was dead if he fell in the river, I don't know.
Yeah, he might have.
Oh gosh. He's losing it. Snowman taking a dip. At least he knows the closest ladder.
Yeah.
Subsector Y? It's hard to tell currently who's in the lead. We've got two different routes going on. It looks like Trep's in the lead because he's in Click Clock Wood, but Trep has to go back to a couple levels. He's got to go back to Spiral Mountain, Mumbo's Mountain, Gobi's Valley, Freeze Easy Peak. So he's got a little bit of backtracking to do before he's done. But Mr. Snowman's just about to get into Click Clock Wood himself, and then he's got about 2 minutes of backtracking as the bee. But we should know. As soon as both players are in Furnace Fun, that's where it'll be synced up. So.
Yeah.
Alright, so I don't think we see another death warp from Trep in Click Clock Wood. Because he's got a Jinjo now. See what I'm sure. Or, no, doesn't he die on the fire here in Fall? In Naughty's house? I don't know. Maybe you get the gingers later. I could have missed it.
Yeah.
Alright, Shinoman's setting himself up for the death warp. Oh, Jinjos do save? Okay, I was confused. I thought Jinjos didn't save.
Alright, time for Schnau to do Click Clock Wood.
This looks a little problematic for Trep here.
Yeah.
I think the closest gold feather for him is by that bird. This is kind of bold. Nice. Ooh, yeah, see? Snowman is topped up on gold feathers. He's got all 10. Trep doesn't have any. It's not a huge issue anymore. You don't really need them until the grunny fight. Yeah, it's really just the bee fight and then the two snare bears that you need them for. Come. We've got some double eerie action here on screen.
Let's go.
Yeah, the, I don't know what it is. I think it's because of the leaves falling. The extra particles just make the nest up there super laggy on N64. Yeah, Click Clockwood hasn't been going the best for Trep here. Oh no!
Rip.
Showman with a nice token grab there. Alright, Trep's got the notes. I didn't even know there was an extra life in the fire. I was confused when Trep was gonna get the witch switch, because he like fell off the house earlier. Thank you. We got a washi machine.
Washi.
This has not been the best click clunk win for Trep here. But we're about to see some serious magic. I can't believe I'm still the hype train conductor. It's literally been that way since the novice tournament finished last time. Cauldron RBA here.
Let's see this. I haven't seen that in a while.
Cauldron RBA is really difficult because you need to overlap two cutscenes, and if you miss the trigger, then I think you have to restart the console.
Yeah, you have to reset it really quickly so it doesn't save.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think you can do the 765 note door clip, so.
No, you don't, because that only works because it has lag, I think. I think that's the only reason why it works. I don't fully know, but I think that might be the reason.
It makes sense to me.
And, yeah, Xbox has, like, barely any lag, so it's not going to work.
Just void out of the top of Mumbos.
Loves the thing of that.
Yeah, it's not like they went in and hard-coded it to be disallowed. It just doesn't function. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the lag assessment is right. Because, like, when you're holding B as the B, like, you're moving pretty quick. And if, like, the game doesn't load the frame where you're trying to, like, exist in the door, then you just threw it. Funny, Trep flew like right into Grunty's mouth. I usually just like land on her shirt. So let's see, what all do we do in Gopies here? Oh, doing the rings, that's funny. Thank you. Nice clip. This is one of the more awkward, like, out of bounds sections.
Yeah.
Trying to optimize all this beam movement would just be a pain. Oh, the camera's like stuck. Yeah, for real, Gogo, I'd be spinning around. Like, I'd have to flap up like 3 times before I got the jiggy. But as Trep is doing this, he's got a couple more levels to get to. He's got to get to Freeze Easy Peak after this. But Snowman's in Fall, so... You know, as you're finishing up Fall, that's the bulk of Click Clock Woods, so...
Yeah.
Wow, incredible main skip.
World record pace.
Grab ain't got nothing on the B. Snowman with another gold split.
Nice.
That seems like a good position for the last statue to be. First try, go be clear.
Let's go. Oh, that's the snowman hit snowman.
Oh. I've been entranced by this bee stuff.
Yeah, Snowman gets destroyed.
Yeah, the Sir Slush have, like, the Eye of an Eagle. Trep saving 30 seconds there. Yeah, the fruities are pretty accurate. Predictive AI.
Oh boy, time for foggy rates.
I should have done a prediction if he gets first try Boggy B race. It's too late now, but. Yeah, this is where it's impossible. Alright. Hopefully he can do it.
I believe.
Yeah, I guess Boggy's coded to, like, accept you as a transformation. But I don't know. It's gotta be weird in this state. Showman getting both winter clips.
Oh shit, that's cool.
Alright, looks like Trep's got it here. Sub Zeros, this is like. Oh no, he missed the gate!
Oh my god, no. This is perfect time for Snowman to catch up.
Yeah. Wait, I think as soon as he's done with this, like, he's done with Freezeezy Peak?
I think so, yeah.
And Snowman's still gotta do all the B movements himself, so.
This is really manga.
Yeah, you're right, Eagle. Thank you, Beach. Alright, fingers crossed.
He gets this side.
Yeah, it's probably just this one. Oh, he missed the last one. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's not that common of a thing to do, but it exists in this Xbox route, and it exists in N64, no FFM. It's wild that it exists and is used.
It's wild that it even exists.
Yeah.
Nice moon, by the way, if you saw that.
Maybe Snowman gets eye gel. Oh, he does! Pretty quick exit.
Pokemon trip. If you do it this time, it could come down to picture questions. No! Yes, that one that swerves to the left there. Eagle, that's an interesting question. I believe he has everything he needs. Yeah, I mean, he routed it this way so that he was gonna get this Jiggy as the beam, so I if you can detransform, then I don't know. Oh my god! Gage got the name change. That's incredible, bud.
Gage now Gage. No, Gage as a sage now Gage. There you go.
Here I go!
Oh wait, why did I get a follow? He got it! He got the gate! Alright, this one seems tricky. No!
Oh. Literally, both. Okay. Like, they're all in stressful spots right now. Holy fuck. This is, like, so scary. Who's gonna win?
Yeah, we'll see if Shinomi gets a picture question, see how fast he can get this to trigger.
Yeah, I don't know what bracket this is.
It, losers round two. He's doing it. Alright, looks like this last one is tricky. Yeah. Alright.
GG.
Wait, so he did get a picture question.
And you got a picture question.
We got a race. Wait, he needs
it's
one
all
more.
Up to the This one's, like, really hard, so...
Yeah, it's pretty awkward getting this set up. But he does get it.
Yo, Trap should go for Ice Key.
Okay.
Nice out of bounds.
So much going on now.
Yeah. Unless Trap golds every single split at this point, I think. Snowman won, but I don't know. I can't call it early.
Yeah, I mean, stuff could go wrong with Grunty, but yeah.
But for now, it seems like Snowman's ahead.
Yeah, he's got at least, like, 2 minutes.
Thank you.
It was a huge time loss for sure, Eagle. Oh, and Trip has text boxes too.
Oh yeah. He still has to do the I don't know what the guy with the
Dingpot.
Yeah, Dingpot. He still has to do the skip.
Yeah. I'm gonna switch over to Snowman's audio. It's gonna be a little quieter, but
yeah.
Snowman could soft lock, that's true, yeah.
Dude, Moose Man on PvP pace and is getting the soft lock.
Was this recently?
It was recently, yeah. He soft locked on like 210 pace, sub 210.
How's your Ninpulk skip?
Alright, let's see. Picture question?
Got it.
Nice, okay. All up to Grunty now.
Oh god, what is this? Yeah, Trep's run was really solid. Up until like Click Clock Wood, where he started falling off the tree a little bit. But... he does get Dingpot skip.
Nice.
Double Grunty, you love to see it. Oh, Trip fell off. GG. Just under 221.
I'll pull Snowman in the call.
Alright.
GG.
Thank you.
Yo, that was an incredible race. Trip, yeah, Trip's still finishing here.
Let me guess, he failed Bobby.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw him, practicing it the other day, and I was struggling. So I was like, if he tries that new route, that'll be my saving grace if he fails that race. Yeah, it's unfortunate though. Let me guess, he failed Bogging. That's the only reason I won.
Yeah, like failed it 10 times.
Yeah. Oh no.
That's so sad.
That's how you get better, no?
Sure.
And the fact that he tried it in a tournament is actually, you gotta give him props, that's impressive.
Yeah.
Especially, you know, how far he's gone.
Yeah.
Yeah, honestly, the race looked like pretty heavily in his favor.
up until that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I had a terrible FP. I had to step away during the twinklies. I think I stayed idle for a good 5-10 seconds, I'm not sure.
Damn. Prep can't get like a grunty in the big bombs.
He must have been on an insane pace to fail Boggy 10 times and still finish almost sub 220.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Yeah, he lost about like 7 minutes.
That, yeah, that's insane. That just goes to show you how much he's improved, though. That's,
yeah.
That's just crazy.
Yeah, I guess he has a 216. Is his PB?
Yeah.
So.
216, yeah.
But yeah, sorry about the delay at the beginning as we got everything sorted out, but.
Yeah, I'm so sorry.
Nah, no worries. Good thing is we didn't have to reschedule.
Yeah.
No.
Just as long as nobody's on a strict schedule or anything.
Yeah, he just started with this route too, maybe what, this week?
You would know better than I.
Yeah, I remember. I haven't been doing it too long.
It definitely seems like a lot of fun.
Yeah, that whole B section is crazy, going all the way back to Spiral Mountain, Mumbo's. This is Gobies, I think, also, if I'm not mistaken. GG, Trap.
Drop a limit.
Wow.
Yo, GG's.
GG, man.
I do not know what to say about that.
A good old Boggy.
Yeah, gotta love him.
Yeah, I peeked in to see where you were, more or less, and I still saw you were at Boggy Race. I was like, oh no. Oh no.